The war rages in Europe, and all the major players are involved in this brutal combat. Last season, the Germans declared war against Switzerland and Belgium and captured those two territories. The Allies responded with a declaration of war against Germany. The British Expeditionary Force landed in Normandy, and France began to prepare its defenses of Paris. This season, the Germans made an attempt at attacking Paris, and after a brutal slugfest, they were defeated and had to withdraw from combat. The British and the French reinforced Paris and counterattacked the Germans in southern France and defeated their air force and army there, leaving very few of the German war machine still alive. The British captured Belgium and captured Western Germany out of the hands of the Germans, and the Polish assisted in that endeavor. The Italians captured Bohemia from the Poles, and the Polish captured Austria from the Germans. As we see, there's a series of back and forths. The Japanese declared war against the USSR, the USSR declared war against the Commonwealth, and again, there was battles back and forth. We see Soviet submarines in the North Sea. We see the Soviet army marching towards Warsaw. We see that the Soviets are marching towards Helsinki, and also the Soviets have marched into Azerbaijan. So brutal conflict on all sides as they battle for supremacy on the continent. The French and the British are strong, but can they withstand the might of what comes at them from the Soviets? Right now, yes, because Soviet production capacity is quite minimal, but perhaps the tide will turn is as the war progresses. This is a very dramatic movement on this side of the world, and it has changed the interventionist strategy here for the Americans. Although our newspaper is out of date, we see that the Americans are now at 43 production points per turn, which is quite a substantial amount, meaning that they are only 19 away from going to war against whoever they choose. So quite the brutal sequence of events. It allows the Americans to start moving their ships about in the Pacific and the Atlantic and be involved in the war a little bit further. The Japanese are still parked outside of Singapore. Perhaps they're going to make an attempt, an attack against Singapore or the newly developing Philippines, or perhaps even Calcutta. We'll see how that would develop. The CCP has now finished aligning some of the more major warlords, taking out Kuomintang, bringing them up to 10 production points of income, needing 13 to achieve a major power. They might be able to achieve that by going to war against and capturing Hong Kong, and perhaps they might be able to do it by taking away some of the KMT territory, but we will have to see how that plays out. Lastly, we have the Anzac over here still storing up their defenses, and the FEC have now moved to the defense of Calcutta. The British are in southern Iran holding out against what the Soviets can throw against them, and that is the development thus far with the game. Hello friends and gamers, my name is Jinx, and we're playing Operation Anthropoid, which is a tier number 2 game for the tournament YouTube Wars that we're doing. We have one more tier after this, and the Allies seem to be in the lead with a decent amount of income, although the Soviets are quite up ahead as well. We rolled for technology, only one success. We've rolled so many dice and so few successes, I've begun to suspect that perhaps a script for the dice rolling software is not up to par, because it doesn't seem to favor our forces whatsoever. All right, let's get started with the KMT. The KMT are purchasing 3 militias with their $6. I'll wipe that out. And we're going to do some non-combat moves. From Sichuan, they're moving 1 infantry down to Hunan. From Shantung, 1 infantry down as well. And that is essentially it for these guys. So we're going to put their new units on the board. Again, there are 3 militia here. So we're going to put 1 over here and 2 in the mountains of Sichuan, so that we can hold out against any CCP attack into our territories. Excellent. And now we turn our attention to the Americans. The Americans have a bit of money coming in. They have $29 that they can purchase with. Now, we have a financial obligations to the Soviets. They lent us, I think it was 9 IPPs worth of resources to the French. And so we're going to return double that. Now, they requested earlier on a fighter plus an artillery, a couple artilleries, meaning that they would get a total of 18 back. They did prefer fighters first, but they didn't really, it's not something that we negotiated what would go first and second. So I have it marked down with a fighter here first. I'm probably going to switch them out and give them a artillery instead if they still want it that way. I'm not sure if I ought to or not, but... And in that case, that's four. That's $6 left over. I might buy an infantry for the British. Yeah. Infantry for the British will go to London. That will help push their attack. And perhaps I'll send infantry out to the French as well. In southern France. Now, I don't know where this task force marker is, if it's still on the board in any capacity. And I'm not seeing it anywhere. But yeah, I'm going to send... I have $6. There's a medium bomber. Fleet number one is over here. Or I could just use it for myself. That's a bit of a tough one. Because we do see the presence of a sizable portion of troops here for these guys. What if I did the French and infantry? And the British and infantry. And maybe in exchange they'll send something to the KMT. Both of them, that would be nice. Okay, I'll do that. I hope they return the favor and I send something out to the KMT. So we're just going to send the British and infantry, French and infantry, and the British and infantry as well. I know it's not a very big bunch of forces, but perhaps it's enough that we can get them to send something our way as well. Okay, so in grand total here, we have $12 on the table from these pieces. 1, 2, 3 for the Airby field, minor port, 1, 2, 3 for the major port upgrade, 1, 2, 3, 4 for two infantries, that's 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Is that right? Seems like I'm over. Let's see, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8, 9, 10, 11, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, okay, I was over. This is 28. 28 total for what we have here. Okay, good. That takes care of that. And again, I'm hoping that the opponents assist us in our allies assist us in the KMT territories with a lend-lease there. Okay, non-combat moves. We're going to send this transport. 1, 2, 3, 6. Just a little bit too far to get anywhere substantial. 1, 2, he's going to come over here because we have to end next to a territory that belongs to us. 1, 2, 3, 4. This guy can go a little bit further. And then we have these two submarines are going to come to P20. Ah, let's go to P30. Nah, P24. And then we have this transport. It's going to go back here, import. And we're going to get these two ships come over here into port. That transport loads up two units. And drops them off over in Hawaii. And then these two fighters also come over to Hawaii as well. Good. And then we're also going to rail some units. Oh, move some dudes here. So this destroyer from A25 goes on escort duty. This one here goes to A18 escort duty. And this one here to A19 escort duty. Then we have these three ships are going to go into port here. Actually, I'm going to send these two destroyers to go 1, 2, 3 on escort duty as well. So he'll go here. And here, I think. Yeah, I think that's about right. You have to be within 3 sea zones, 1, 2, 3 of our territory. So I think that works. So two transports there. I'm going to rail some 4 units across to the other side. The seaplane is going to fly up here. And these guys are all going to be railed to the other coast. Let's see. Right here. Okay. These two coastal subs are going to come down one space. These ships are going to come here. And these ships from the Gulf of Mexico here as well. Perfect. I think that about does it for us. All right, now we're going to put our pieces on the board. So I'll grab all of this, except we're not building that artillery. We'll start on this side here. So as I understand it, because I'm at peace with the Italians, I could send this this French unit all the way to southern France. The Brits can receive this in London. Sure. And the Soviets receive their artillery piece. Let's put in this 74 position. I think I can go there. I won't be interdicted. Yeah. And then I have these pieces. So major port upgrade is going to come down here in Panama. So that we get that boost of movement. And then these guys are going to come to the other side, to the Philippines. We're putting some effort into the Philippines this turn. Okay, we're going to put an anti-aircraft gun here. We're going to build this minor port here and begin the workings of an airfield here. And I guess I should put a construction marker underneath it. Ba-ba-ba-ba-ba. Damage under construction. There we have it. Okay, and lastly, we have two militia. So I'm going to upgrade a militia with that equivalent of money and place the militia. So there we have it. Five infantry, an anti-aircraft gun, and a militia in Luzon and Visayas. I'm going to have to put a task force marker there in the future. And that concludes all of our moves, to my knowledge. Okay, now we go to collecting cafes. So we had $1 left over. With $1 plus 43 brings us up to 44 bucks for the next turn. Yeah, 44 bucks to spend on our subsequent turn. Good. All right, that is it. Let's erase some lines. Okay, everybody. Thank you all for watching. Cheers.